Hi, my name is Amanda Gustin. I'm the Public Program Manager at the Vermont Historical Society, and today I'm going to tell you a little bit about this really wonderful painting from our collections. It's one of my favorites, so I'm glad I get to share it with you. This is a painting called The Whipples, and it's by an artist named Hilda Belcher. Hilda Belcher was born in Pittsford, Vermont in 1881, and she grew up there. When she was a teenager, she and her family moved down to New Jersey, but they kept the house in Pittsford. So Hilda Belcher graduated from high school and immediately after that began training as an artist. Now her mother was an artist, so it ran in the family, Martha Wood Belcher, also a well-known Vermont artist. Her father owned a company that made, among other things, stained glass, so there was some artistic tendency in the family already. So after graduating from high school, she moved to New York City to attend art school. So pretty quickly, Hilda Belcher began earning prizes for her work. Most of her early work was in watercolor, and she gained entry to various watercolor societies and gained various prizes based on her watercolor work. She exhibited regularly as a young woman, already in her 20s and 30s, gaining acclaim in the art world. So Hilda also earned money doing illustrations for magazines and newspapers, usually illustrating either nonfiction reporting or fictional stories in a wide variety of newspapers and magazines at the time. She was well recognized in her own time as a talented artist. In fact, she became only the second woman ever elected to the National Academy of Design in 1932. So by the 1940s, Hilda Belcher's health was not good, and she largely moved back to Pittsford, Vermont, to that family house, and did a little bit of paint, continued to do a little bit of painting, but after 1940 or so, she only rarely exhibited new work. This painting is dated 1950 and is called The Whipples because it features three children from the neighborhood, three Whipple children. The youngest here would have been 3 years old at the time, and the oldest here would have been 10. That's Nellie, Leon, who was known as Joe, and Philip in the center. I like this painting quite a lot because it shows each of these children as individual personalities. You can really get a sense very quickly of who they were. He's looking a little bit sulky. I like the little one in the center is looking just a touch mischievous, just looking straight on at the painter there. And our oldest girl, Nellie, has a sort of a dreamy look to her. This is a sort of an interesting contrast to sort of like a 19th century portrait of children when they were expected to be little adults, very serious, very studious in their portraits. There's just a lot going on here. The painting technique is also interesting too. In some cases, you can see just straight blank canvas. In other cases, there's quite a thickness of painting. So she's really working with her technique in this painting. Although she gained early fame working in watercolor, she also did pen and ink illustration. And this painting here is oil. So she had talents in a wide variety of types of art. Thanks for joining us. To learn more about objects from the collections of the Vermont Historical Society, make sure you visit our website, vermonthistory.org, and follow us on social media.